झूले झूले गौरा हरि गुण गाए,
झूले झूले गौरा हरि गुण गाए,
झूले झूले गौरा हरि
नामे मत्त होए हरि नासी चे देई,
हरि नामे मत्त होए हरि नासी चे देई,
मयूरा मयूरी प्रेमे
मयूरा मयूरी प्रेमे,
मयूरा मयूरी प्रेमे,
मयूरा मयूरी प्रेमे,
नचिया खिला
नचिया खिला,
डूले डूले गौराचा हरि गुण गाए,
डूले डूले गौराचा हरि गुण गाए,
प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि हरि बोलो बदन भोरी,
प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि बोलो बोलो बदन भोरी,
प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि हरि बोलो बदन भोरी,
प्राणे हरि ध्याने हरि हरि बोलो बदन भोरी,
हरि नाम गे ये गे,
हरि नाम गे ये गे,
हरि नाम गे गे,
हरि नाम गे ये गे,
रस गोले जाए
रस गोले जाए,
डूले डूले गौराचा हरि गुण गाए,
डूले डूले गौराचा हरि गुण गाए,
आसिया जमुनार कुले नाचे हरि हरि बोले,
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 जमुना उठोले से
जमुना उठोले से,
जमुना उठोले से
जमुना उठोले से,
चरण धोया
चरण धोया,
डूले डूले गौराचा हरि गुण गाए,
डूले डूले गौराचा हरि गुण गाए,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे रामा राम राम हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे,
हरे कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे
हरे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे
हरे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम राम राम
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम राम राम
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम राम हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम
राम राम हरे हरे
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद
जय जय श्री चैतन्य जय नित्यानंद
जय नित्यानंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद
जय द्वैत चंद्र जय गौर भक्तवृंद
श्री श्री गौर नेताय की बलिग पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की श्री प्रभुपाद की, कृष्णदास कविराज गोस्वामी की, चैतन्य चरितामृत की। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुः उन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। श्रीचैतन्यमनोभीष्टं स्थापितं येन भूतले स्वयं रूपः कदा मह्यं ददाति स्वपदान्तिकम्। वन्देऽहं श्रीगुरोः श्रीयुतपदकमलं श्रीगुरून् वैष्णवांश्च श्रीरूपं साग्रजातं सहगणरघुनाथान्वितं तं सजीवम् साद्वैतं सावधूतं परिजनसहितं कृष्णचैतन्यदेवं श्रीराधाकृष्णपादान् सहगणललिता श्रीविशाखान्वितांश्च। नमः ॐ विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्तस्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सारस्वते देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषशून्यवादि पाश्चात्यदेशधारिणे। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्णप्रेमप्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्णचैतन्यनाम्ने गौरत्विषे नमः। हे कृष्णकरुणासिन्धो दीनबन्धो जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिकाकान्तराधाकान्त नमोऽस्तुते। तप्तकाञ्चन गौराङ्गी राधे वृन्दावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये। वाञ्छाकल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपासिन्धुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर श्रीवासादि गौर भक्तवृंद। हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे, हरे राम 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 हरे हरे। हरे कृष्ण, वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू फॉर द 9th वर्स ऑफ द भक्ति शास्त्री Nectar of Instruction course. So in the 8th verse, we had learned some things. Sloka number 8. Tannama rupa charitadi sukirtanana smrityo krameena rasanamana si niyojya tishthan prajeta dhanuragi jananugami kalam nayeda kilamityupadesha saram. That was a shloka, and the main conclusion of that previous shloka, that is 8th shloka, was about shravanam, hearing, going from shravana dasha, varana dasha, smarana avastha, and then sampatti dasha. All are higher and higher levels of deep hearing with absorption, and so much so that such intensive hearing about Krishna Katha, of Nama Rupa Guna Leela of Krishna, that leads to Samadhi, which is called Anusmriti, continued remembrance, concentrated meditation and remembrance. So, if one continues to hear like that, one goes from Vaidhi Bhakti to Raganuga Bhakti. So, we had mentioned there that one should stay in Vraja and follow the example of one great Vrajavasi, pure devotee of the Lord, Nitya Siddha. And externally one should do the Vaidhi Bhakti type of rules and regulations, but internally one should cultivate the mood of being one of the eternal associates of Krishna. One should take them as an example and follow in their footsteps. So these are some things we discussed. 5 rasas also we discussed last time.
Lobe vraja vasi rabhave kare anugati.
Kare anugati.
Chastra yukti nahi mane raganugara prakriti.
Chastra yukti nahi mane raganugara prakriti.
What is the meaning of this? Lobe vraja vasi rabhave bhave. Kare anugati. In Vrindavan, the Vrajavasis actually are activated by their lobha or by the greed for Krishna. So, just like electric current activates wire and makes it live wire, and the movement of the fan is caused by the electricity passing through a wire. In the same manner, the prema bhakti passes through the body of the Vrajabasis, and they are activated by prema, not by rules and regulations. That's what he is saying. Shastra yukti. It's not that shastras have to say, rise early in the morning, therefore they will get up. It's not like that. Shastra yukti nahi mane. Raganugara prakriti. This is the nature of spontaneous devotion. Bahya, what is externally?
Externally, one performs hearing and chanting in the sadhaka deha, the outer feature of the practitioner.
Antara?
Internally, while contemplating one's own perfected spiritual form, one renders service to Sri Krishna in Vraja day and night. While residing in Vraja, one should immerse oneself in hearing narrations of the eternal devotees who serve in the mood for which one aspires. Mm. This is the essence of all instruction in the matter of bhakti.
This we learned in the text 8. Yeah.
There is no greater place than Vraja Mandal to perform bhajana of Sri Radha Krishna. Therefore, even such exalted devotees as Brahma and Uddhava pray to take birth there as a blade of grass or a shrub.
So Brahma says, Tad bhuri bhagyamiha janmakim api atavyam yad gokule pikatamangri rajobhishekam. Similarly, Uddhava also says, Asamaho charana renu jushamaham syam vrindavane kimapi gulmala taushadinam yadustyajam charanam adyapatam chahitva veju mukunda padavim shruti birbhimrgyam. So, Uddhava says that after talking to gopis and seeing their deep Krishna consciousness, Uddhava said this prayer. My Lord, I wish to become a tree in Vrindavan, he said. Then he said, become a tree, how will I get the mercy of the gopis? Then he said, I want to become a creeper in Vrindavan, he said. And then he thought, creeper also is not good enough. Better let me become a grass in Vrindavan, because then only gopis will walk over me, and I will get the dust off their feet. So like that, kimapi gulmalata aushadinam, like that he says. So, he desired to become a grass and get the dust of the gopis that goes to show the glory of the Vrindavan Dham. This is the essence of our instruction in the matter of bhakti. Today we are proceeding to the 9th shloka. This is text number 9 of Netter of Instruction.
Vaikuntha janito varamadupuri tatrapi rasotsavad.
Vaikuntha janito varamadhupuri tatrapi rasotsavat
vrindaranyam budara pani ramanat tatrapi govardhanah
vrindaranyam budara pani ramanat tatrapi govardhanah
radhakundamihapi gokulapate premamrita plavanat
Radhakundam mihapi gokulapate premamritaplavanat
kuryadasya virajato giritate sevam vivekinah nakah
kuryadasya virajato giritate sevam vivekinah.
Beautiful verse, no? Let's say it once more, let's say.
Vaikuntha janito vara madhupuri tatrapi rasotsavat
Vaikuntha janito vara madhupuri tatrapi rasotsavat
Vrindaranyam budara pani ramana tatrapi govardhanah
Vrindaranyam mudara pani ramanat tatrapi govardhanah
Radhakundamihapi gokulapate Premamrita plavanat
Radha kundam mihapi gokulapate Premamrita plavanat
Kuryadasya virajato giritate Sevam vivekinakah
Kuryadasya virajato giritate Sevam vivekinakah.
Yeah.
The holy place known as Mathura is spiritually superior to Vaikuntha, the transcendental world, because the Lord appeared there. Superior to Mathurapuri is the transcendental forest of Vrindavan because of Krishna's Ras Lila pastimes. And superior to the forest of Vrindavan is Govardhan Hill, for it was raised by the divine hand of Sri Krishna and was the site of his various loving pastimes. And above all, the super excellent Sri Radha Kunda stands supreme, for it is flooded with the ambrosial nectarian prema of the Lord of Gokula, Sri Krishna. Where, then, is that intelligent person who is unwilling to serve this divine Radha Kunda, which is situated at the foot of Govardhan Hill?
So, this is what we read just now. Amongst the planets in Vaikuntha, we call it Vaikuntha sky. Mathura Mandal is special. In near Mathura Mandal, Vrindavan is special. In Vrindavan, Govardhan Hill is special. And in Govardhan Hill, if you go on Parikrama, the spot where Radha Kunda is there, that is the most special. There are spiritually of higher and higher and higher levels, it explains. See, this is Vaikuntha. In Vaikuntha, what is most predominant is the Aishwarya Bhava. Great respect. Lakshmi Narayan are sitting, in the elevated throne. And all the servants and servant maids called Vishnudutas and Vaikuntha Vasis. You see them rendering varieties of service to Lord. Bringing flowers, making garlands, and offering garland to Lord, and singing for the pleasure of the Lord, dancing for the pleasure of the Lord, and offering different bhoga to the Lord. Entering varieties of services like that. And also, as you observe, the Vaikuntha is an extremely opulent place. Like you see the large doors bedecked with, studded with gems and jewels, and huge gopurams, and all decorated with, lapis lazuli. Prabhupada says lapis lazuli means vaidurium. Vaidurium, gold and silver and diamond and everything, coral. Actually, in the material world, what we have is insignificant reflection, tiny reflection of what is there in the Vaikuntha planets. Here you find the four Kumaras coming to the door of Vaikuntha and they are stopped. And now think seriously, is there a need for a door in Vaikuntha? Is there a need for a watchman in Vaikuntha to see who will come in, who will not come in? Because Lord is completely in control in Vaikuntha. These are not required, but out of respect and affection for the Lord, some devotees desire to become watchmen and also have a door to offer protection to Lord. So there is affection also in Vaikuntha, but that affection is mixed with Aishwarya Bhava, great reverence and respect for the Lord. So, then he says, better than Vaikuntha is which place? He said, Mathura, he said, where Krishna appeared in the jail of Kamsa. Now, of course, Krishna and Balaram appeared in, Krishna appeared in the jail of Kamsa and was transported, as you all know, to Nanda Gokulam. After performing pastimes in Nanda Gokulam for 11 years, then Krishna and Balaram, they come to Mathura. Akrura comes to take them. So here you are finding Krishna Balaram walking in the roads of Mathura, and all the ladies of Mathura going to the rooftops and showering flowers, and all Mathuravasis welcoming him with great respect. You can see here. They are performing aarti, they are bowing down to the feet. So just as I was telling you about Vaikuntha, Mathura is also a place filled with a lot of reverence. Beginning with Devaki and Vasudeva showing reverential admiration for Krishna. As soon as Krishna appeared in the jail, Devaki offered namaskar to him. There are pictures of Devaki Vasudeva doing Dandavat Pranam to their own child Krishna. Because they felt this is a lot. God has come as our child. So reverence is very high in Mathura. Now also you find all people watching the Lord with great reverence. And here you find Lord is coming to the Sudama florist. Sudama florist's shop, and then he is offering him a garland and offering him obeisances, isn't it? For Krishna Balaram. Then you find this Kubja. Lord is delivering Kubja from the hunchbacked body, giving her a beautiful body of a young girl. So, in this way, here you find the Lord is doing magic, miracles to prove His greatness. This is Mathura. Here again, the Lord is displaying His majesty. He breaks the bhav, the Dhanur Yajna. and using the broken bow, Krishna and Balaram took one part of the bow, one piece of the bow, and they started attacking all the Kamsa's men and defeated them very easily. And after he crossed that Dhanuryagna area, he came to area where he found there's a huge elephant called Kovalayapida. And the Kovalayapida was actually deputed by Kamsa to attack Krishna Balaram and destroy them. Of course, Krishna killed the Kovalayapida in a very intelligent way. He evaded the Kovalayapida wanted to use his tusks to stab Krishna. But Krishna would evade him in such a way that he would put his tusk in the ground. And he would exactly go behind his tail and stand. Searching, where is he? He went round and round. Finally, Krishna caught hold of his trunk and twisted him, made him fall on the ground. He killed Kovalayapida, very powerful elephant. So all these things go to show the power of Lord Krishna, yeah. Great majesty and power of Lord Krishna and Balaram. Again, you see a display of majesty when Krishna goes to the wrestling arena, where thousands of people are sitting on the stadium and watching. Mallanam Ashanendranam Naravarastrinam Smaro Murtiman Gopanam Swajano Satam Shidibhujam Shasta Swapitro Shishuhu Mrityur Bhojapate Virra Virata Vidusham Satyam Param Yoginam Krishninam Paradeva Deti Vidito Rangam Gatasa Graja. This verse comes in the 10th canto of Srimad Bhagavatam. This verse says, Mallanam Ashanir, it says, the Malla, like Chana and Mushtik, they felt Krishna's beating like a thunderbolt, hitting their body, boom, very strong. Although Krishna's body looks very tender and soft here, then all the Vajabasis, covered men and their wives, their ladies are worried, what will happen to the soft body of Krishna? This Mallas are very, very hefty. But then Krishna gave them a blow like thunderbolt, it is said. And Rinam Naravara, the men in the Sabha considered Krishna to be the best personality. And Strinam Smaro Murtiman, all the women considered Krishna to be Cupid incarnate, or the original Cupid, who is attractive even to the Cupid himself. And Gopanam Swajano, all the covered boys were very happy. They were very happy to see Krishna Balaram showing their, you know, power of display power of their power. Because they have seen Krishna killing many demons. Now they are watching Krishna doing wrestling. So they were delighting in that. Gopanam, Swajano. They considered Krishna to be their own friend. The covered men considered Krishna to be their own child like that. And Gopanam, Swajano, Asatam, Kshitibhujam. Kshitibhujam, Shasta, Swapitro, Shishu. Kshitibhujam, Shasta. He says, punisher of the chastiser of the evil. That's the meaning. So those who are burdensome to the earth, the demons, the Lord becomes a chastiser of those people. Aswapitro Shishu, like Nanda Baba Yashoda, they thought he is our Shishu. He is our child. Or even the other covered men and ladies, elderly ones, they thought Krishna is like our own Shishu. Yeah. And Mrityur Bhojapate, and Kamsa, when he looked at Krishna, see, he is sitting in the chair in the top. From there is watching. He saw Krishna like death personified. Mrityur Bhojapate, it says. Mrityur Bhojapate, yeah, because the Lord Krishna's body is very tender and soft and beautiful. Look at him. Vajavasis are seeing him in that way only. But when Kamsa saw Krishna's body, he looked like Virat Purusha for him. Because Virat Purusha is the material form of the Lord. But the Lord displayed him the dangerous and fearsome material form with sun and moon as the eyes. So he saw like that. Kamsa, he got frightened. Mrityur Bhojapate, my Mrityu has come, he thought like that. And Virat Abhidusham. There are impersonalists, preliminary stage impersonalists. They saw him as a Virat Purusha. They saw the material form of Lord. They could not see the spiritual form. Tattvam Param Yogina. And the yogis were sitting in the Sabha. They saw Krishna as a, you know, Lord of their hearts, the Antaryami, super soul. Tattvam Param Yogina. And Vrishninam, the Yadus, Vishninam Paradevateti, he is our supreme worshipable deity. He is our most wonderful lord of Dwaraka. They saw like that. Rangam Gatasagraja, that is in the Rangamanch, when Lord appeared. So Mathura is actually a place of tremendous Aishwarya Bhava, reverence. Where Krishna displays one after another several series of incidents, public open display of his prowess. And everybody can watch his prowess, although he looks very tender and dashing. He is extremely mighty and powerful. And not only he kills Shalatoshala, Krishna Balaram, they finish Shalatoshala. He also finishes Kamsa, as you see here. He drags Kamsa out of his seat and finishes Kamsa. In this way, Mathura is full of Aishwarya display. Then we may ask a question, why is Mathura being a place of Aishwarya, superior to Vaikuntha, which is also a place of Aishwarya? Both are place of Aishwarya Bhava or reverence. Then why should one be considered greater than the other? And the reason Prabhupada says, Mathura is the place of birth of Krishna. Krishna's Jayanti, the birth happens in Kamsa's jail. There is a beautiful verse which talks about Krishna's appearance in the jail of Kamsa. So you can see this beautiful verse on the head.
Tamadbhutam balakam ambujekshanam.
Tamadbhutam balakam ambujekshanam.
Chaturbhujam shankha gadadyudayudham.
Chaturbhujam shankha gadadyudayudham.
Shrivatsalakshmam galashobhikaustubham.
Shrivatsalakshmam galashobhikaustubham.
Pitambaram sandrapayodasaubhagam.
Pitambaram sandrapayodasaubhagam.
You understand the meaning? Very beautiful meaning. Tamadbhutam balakam, he's saying. And the child who was born in the jail of Kamsa is not an ordinary child. What child he was? Adbhuta Balakam. Wonderful child. And why he was a wonderful child? Because he was a speaking child, smiling child, child wearing Kaustubha mani and all jewelry, child wearing beautiful pitambar dress and curly locks of hair, the mukut and kundal. Have you ever seen a child born like that? He was born like that. Therefore, he is Adbhuta Balakam. Not only that, he was reminding the parents of their two previous births. Your Prishni and Sadapa, I came as Prishni Garbha. Your Aditi and Kashyapa, I came as Vamana. Now you come as Devaki Vasudeva and I am coming as Vasudeva, Krishna. So in this way, the child was a speaking child. And Ambujekshanam, he had eyes like lotus petals. Chaturbhujam, he had four hands. Shankha, Gada, all this ayudham he was carrying also. And Srivatsa Lakshmam, he had a golden hair in the chest. Kalashobi Kaustubam, he was wearing a Kaustubha necklace beautifully. And Pitambaram, he was wearing a Pitambar dress. In this, all these details are given. You can see that.
Maharga Vaiduriya Kirita Kundala.
Maharya Vaiduriya Kirita Kundala.
Tvisha Parishvakta Sahasra Kuntalam.
Tvisha Parishvakta Sahasra Kuntalam.
Uddama Kanchangadakam Karnadibhir.
Uddama Kanchiyangadakam Karnadibhir.
Virochamanam Vasudeva Aikshata.
Virochamanam Vasudeva Aikshata.
Yeah. So, he was wearing a Vaidurya, beautiful Kirita Kundala, wearing Mukutu, shining with Vaidurya manis. And Kundal he was wearing, beautiful Kundal in the ears, like shark shaped earrings. In this way, Sahasra Kuntalam, he had curly locks of blackish hair also. Have you ever seen a child born with thick curly locks of blackish hair? He was born like that. Yeah. And he was wearing Kanchi Angada Kankana Adibir. Golden bangles he was wearing in the hands, bracelets, amulets, and nopur. All the ornaments were there in his body. Virochamanam Vasudeva Aikshata. And this beautiful, shining, brilliant child was seen by Vasudeva, his father, with great amazement. He was greatly stunned, like that he explains. Yeah. So, this is the birth of Lord Krishna. If you see, prior to this, see the symptoms of Krishna's appearance here. You'll be amazed. When Lord appears, therefore Mathura is special, he says here. See.
अथ सर्वगुणोपेतः
अथ सर्वगुणोपेतः
कालः परमशोभनः
कालः परमशोभनः
यर्हेवाजनजन्मर्क्षम्
शान्तर्क्षग्रहतारकम्
He's saying, when Krishna appeared on that day, what happened? Sarvagunopeta, he's saying. All the special qualities appeared in the nature, beginning with Kala Paramashovanaha. The time became completely favorable and it beautified everything. And then he's going to say, well, each of the items he is explaining here. You can see this. You can read that. Yeah.
Thereafter, at the auspicious time for the appearance of the Lord, the entire universe was surcharged with all the qualities of goodness, beauty and peace.
Yeah.
The constellation...
Kala Paramashobanaha. Sarva Gunopeta means all the qualities of goodness came everywhere. Because passion and Tamaguna and Rajaguna are in the day and night. But the goodness is the early morning hour. So, at that time everywhere everybody found the beauty and peace. At that time, yes.
The constellation Rohini appeared, as did stars like Ashwini. The sun, the moon and the other stars and planets were very peaceful. All directions appeared extremely pleasing and the beautiful stars twinkled in the cloudless sky. Decorated with towns, villages, mines and pasturing grounds, the earth seemed all auspicious. The rivers flowed with clear water and the lakes and vast reservoirs full of lilies and lotuses were extraordinarily beautiful. In the trees and green plants, full of flowers and leaves, pleasing to the eyes, birds like cuckoos and swarms of bees began chanting with sweet voices for the sake of the demigods. A pure breeze began to flow, pleasing the sense of touch and bearing the aroma of flowers. And when the brahmanas, engaging in ritualistic ceremonies, ignited their fires according to Vedic principles, the fires burned steadily, undisturbed by the breeze.
So in this way you are saying, the lotuses and lilies in the ponds, the cuckoos were cooing, peacocks were dancing, mild wind was blowing. The moon was thinking that, oh, although it is Ashtami, I am supposed to be a crescent moon, but my Lord Krishna has appeared in Chandravamsh, so I will show my full moon. So he gave a full moon darshan like that. And all the, everywhere there was greenery, gardens blooming with flowers. And also, the brahmanas became very confident now that Lord has appeared now to kill the demons. Correct, no? Dharma samsthapana arthaya sambhavami yugyayi. So Lord has come now. So brahmanas lost all their fear of Kamsa. They all started reciting. Sahastra shir sapurushaha sahastraksha sahastrapat sabhumim vishvato vritvan atyadishtad dashangulam purushaye vedakum sarvam yad bhutam yad chabhavyam utamrtat pashyeshanaha yadannena pirohati ishavanasya mahima. It went on. And this is the brahmana's chant was vibrating in all directions. Everybody became joyful hearing those Purushasukta prayers, glorification of the Lord. And in this way, at that time what happened? Thus when birthless Lord Vishnu.
Thus, when the birthless Lord Vishnu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, was about to appear, the saints and brahmanas, who had always been disturbed by demons like Kamsa and his men, felt peace within the core of their hearts and kettle drums simultaneously vibrated from the upper planetary system.
There were flowers showered from the upper planetary system and musical instruments were played. In this way, everything became auspicious. You can see that this is the appearance of Lord Krishna.
Jagukkinnara gandharvaha
जगुः किन्नर गंधर्वाः
तुष्टुवुः सिद्धचारणाः
तुष्टुवुः सिद्धचारणाः
विद्याधर्यश्च नन्रुतुर्
विद्याधर्यश्च नन्रुतुर्
अप्सरोभिः समं मुदा
अप्सरोभिः समं मुदा.
This way the kinnaras and gandharvas, what they were doing, oh, sorry,
The Kinnaras and Gandharvas began to sing auspicious songs. The Siddhas and Charanas offered auspicious prayers. And the Vidyadharis, along with Apsaras, began to dance in jubilation.
Yeah. So, in this way, Siddhas and Charanas are offering chant, Vedic chant, to glorify the Lord. And Vidyadharis and Apsaras are dancing. And the Gandharvas and Kinnaras are singing. So, those who can sing, they are singing. Those who can chant mantras, they are chanting. Those who can dance are dancing. Everybody in glorification of Krishna.
Mumuchur munayo devaha.
Sumanam simudanvitaha. Mandam mandam jaladhara. Jagarjuranusagaram. Mumuchur munayo devaha. Sumanamsi. Mudanvitaha. They are all very pleased, the demigods as well as acha more are there.
Nishite tam udbhute.
Jayamane janardane.
Devakyam devarupinyam.
Vishnu sarva guhashayah.
Avirasidya tatha prachyam.
Dishin duriva pushkalah.
The demigods and great saintly persons showered flowers in a joyous mood, and clouds gathered in the sky and very mildly thundered.
Why they mildly thundered? Because they didn't want to disturb Lord Krishna. He has just appeared. They want to give him a pleasing experience. So they mildly thundered. Yeah.
Making sounds like those of the ocean's waves. Then the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, who is situated in the core of everyone's heart, appeared from the heart of Devaki in the dense darkness of night, like the full moon rising on the eastern horizon, because Devaki was of the same category as Shri Krishna.
Yeah. So the cloud said, "Hey ocean, you are very fortunate because you are connected with Lord Krishna's name. Your name is, Krishna said as, hey Krishna Karuna Sindhu. So your Sindhu name is included in Krishna's name as Karuna Sindhu." The ocean said, "You are also no less, Lord is called Ghanashyam. So you are also Ghana Bhadal." Like that he said. So in this way, in the nature, everybody was talking to each other about the appearance of Lord Krishna. And in this way, eventually you will see that then Lord Krishna was taken by, it goes on like this. Okay, we'll recite one. This we recited just now. Tamadbhutam Balakam Ambujekshana. Isn't it? Yeah. Vasudeva was amazed. After that, Vasudeva will take Krishna in a basket, and the gates of the jail will open, break open. His chains will open also. Everything will break apart. Then when he is going, many miraculous things happen. For example, Anantashish comes to give him shelter. And Indra is showering rain in order to make all the people go into their homes and close the doors and windows and go to sleep, so that nobody will watch Krishna being carried. Kamsa's men, nobody will be around. So Indra is showering rain, but the beauty is what? Not even a drop of rain falls on Krishna's body. Like that, he pours everywhere other than the place where Krishna is being carried. So these are all miracles. Aishwarya, reverence, because Lord has descended now and is being carried to Nanda Gokulam. In this way, Yamuna gives way and he has to cross. So you will find this is Vasudev Krishna when he appears. This kind of great respect you will find in Mathura. Now, better than Mathura, he says in that verse is Vrindavan, he says. So, what is so special about Vrindavan? Vrindavan is the home of the Lord. Vaikuntha is the parliament of the Lord. That's the prime minister has a home and a parliament. In parliament, the prime minister receives respect. The home, the prime minister receives affection from the very near and dear relatives who are extremely trustworthy for him. They are his inner circle people. And any man, when he returns home, he knows he is with his confidential associates at home, his mother, his father, his brother, sister, wife, children. One feels very comfortable at home. They cook nice things and give him, spend time with him. He can spend very casually, leisurely. So, Vrindavan is such a place for Krishna. The main difference between Vrindavan and Vaikuntha, you will see. In Vaikuntha or Dwaraka or Mathura, the situation is more like putting the Lord in a position of a great warrior or a king, wearing kavacha in his body and mukut and kundal and carrying a bow and arrow, fighting the battle, killing big demons, fighting against people like Jarasandha and Kalayavana and such kinds of people. And Lord Vasudeva has a very reverential role, Mathura, Dwaraka and Vaikuntha also. Whereas in Vrindavan, the Lord doesn't play the role of God or a great king or anything like that. Godhead gives up his godhood due to the intimacy and love of his devotees in Vrindavan. So, here you find this is Uddhava who has come to give a message to the gopis. Many gopis who heard the message from Uddhava, as Uddhava started speaking pastimes of Krishna, you can see many of the gopis went into the mood of narrating those pastimes, demonstrating those pastimes. And Uddhava was amazed how much they are absorbed in Krishna Leela, land where the Yamuna is flowing, the gardens are blooming with flowers, hummingbees are humming, cuckoos are cooing, peacocks are dancing, cows and calves, and the deers, they hanker to hear the sweet flute sound of the Lord. And the gopas go with Krishna to the forest to herd the cows and calves. That is only an excuse for which they go to forest, but the actual activity they wish to do is to play with Krishna, varieties of games. And topmost of the devotees amongst the covered boys and his parents and gopis are the gopis. Like you see here, see this very beautiful picture of Krishna playing on the flute and all the gopis. Mad after the flute, they all are running to join the rasa dance with Lord Krishna. So, sarvadharman parityajya mamekam sharanam praja aham tvam sarva papyebhyo mokshayishyami mashachah. That sloka is practiced by these gopis. Sharanagati to Lord Krishna. Not caring for wealth, not caring for one's personal belongings or status or any other security or protection in life. All the gopis are ready to throw everything to the wind and run to Lord Krishna to go and surrender to him. So, that's what our Uddhava admired. He says, Ya dustyajam swajanam arya patam chahitva. He says that for a woman in this world, the protection of father and brother and husband and children and mother, family is a very important thing. Whereas all these gopis, they actually attained the highest status of life, where they attained the lotus feet of Krishna, and not caring for anything of this world. And therefore, Prabhupada explains this rasa dance of the gopis with Krishna is a completely spiritual dance, because the gopis' bodies were at, whereas they all emerged in their spiritual bodies and went and danced with Krishna. So, if you read the Gopi Gitam, it gives you a clue on what type of devotees the gopis were. So, one or two prayers I will tell you, you will see what amazing prayers they are offering.
Jayati te dikam janmana vraja jayatayandira shashvadatrahi daita drishyata dekshutavata tvayidrita savas vam vichinvate.
They are saying, my dear Krishna, ever since you appeared in Vrindavan, the auspiciousness of Raja has increased a million times more. And seeing your lotus feet in Vrindavan, even Lakshmiji is coming and residing here. Shrayata Indira. Indira means Lakshmi. Wherever Narayana goes, Lakshmi follows Narayana's footsteps. So you have come here, so she has also come. And because she has come here, you know, the opulence of Vrindavan is even multiplied several more times, as they are saying. And then such a lovable and very dear Lord to all our hearts, why is it that you have left our rasa dance and you are absconding, you have disappeared from our sight? Please do not make us become broken hearted like this. We are all searching for you, asking the plants, asking the trees, asking the deers, asking all the other forest creatures about your whereabouts.
Sharadudashaye sadhu jatasat sarasi jodara shri mushadrusha suratanat te shukadasika varadane ghnato neha kyum varaha.
O Lord, you are like a sun and we are like, our faces are like a lotus. You know, when the lotus gets to see the sun, the lotus blossoms. Similarly, in your presence, all our faces blossom like a full-blown lotus. But when the sun is away in the night time, all the lotuses are closed. Similarly, since you have disappeared from our sight now, we are unable to see you. So, our faces have become dried up. We have become like a dried up lotus and our faces have become very morose, like that they are saying. Why are you killing us like this? They are asking. You have vanished from our sight and your going away from us has made us feel a great viraha, and they are missing you like a lotus missing the beautiful sun, they are saying.
Prasti samvido yahrdi sprashah kuhakano manah kshobhayanti.
They are saying kuhaka means a cheater. A great cheater. You have performed beautiful pastimes in Raja, giving great pleasure to Yashoda, Nanda, covered boys, covered girls, cows, calves, everybody. And those pastimes which you performed cannot be forgotten.
Rahasi sammito yahrdi sprashah kuhakano manah kshobhayanti.
They are saying, yahrdi sprashah means those pastimes are all heart touching. We cannot forget them. But you gave those pastimes to all of us to remember and then you disappeared. So are you not a cheater? You have, it's like somebody gave you 10 crore rupees and then took it away and ran away. It's like that. You gave such a great wealth of your pastimes. Now you are not showing yourself. Where are you? And then they are saying,
Tava katamritam tapta jivanam shravana mangalam shrimadatatam.
They are saying, tavakata amritam tapta jivanam. Our hearts are like a dry desert. And in that desert, imagine if there is a rain pour with a huge clouds appearing in the sky. In the hot sun, the desert is completely dry, but the rain shower makes it very fertile and fresh. Similarly, your kathas are like that. They are saying, your kathas are like a rain shower in a desert. like heart like ours. And Kavi Biriditam Kalma Shapaham, they are saying, which means great learned devotees of yours, they always narrate these pastimes to the people and rejuvenate the hearts and lives of millions of people in the world.
Shravana Mangalam Srimadatatam Guvi Grinanti Ye Buridajana Guvi Grinanti Ye Buridajana.
They are saying that your pastimes are all very auspicious. Shravana Mangalam, Srimad Atatam, they bring all good fortune to your devotees who hear your pastimes. And therefore, Bhuvi Granantya means in this world, those Katha speakers, Vaishnavas, who are taking your message to the people, they are the greatest charitable welfare workers, like that they are saying.
Atati yadvajat ahnikananam kruter yogayate twamapashyatam kutilakuntalam shrimukham chate Jadavudikshata Pakshmadrusha.
They are saying Atati Yadvrajat means Atati means the forest. In the daytime, you go to the forest with your covered boyfriends and calves in the morning time. And at that time we get to see you, but then once you enter into forest, we have no access to see you. Nor can we leave our homes and come to the forest. Although we are desperate to join you and we want to see what you do in the forest, how you play with the covered boys, how you kill demons, how you herd the cows and calves, how you play on your flute, how you eat your lunch. But since we cannot accompany you and see you due to the social restriction, we sit amongst ourselves, gopis, and we discuss katha. Right now Krishna must have gone there, 10 o'clock there, 11 o'clock here, 1 o'clock here. We keep talking about you amongst ourselves, and we are very hopefully and eagerly awaiting your return in the evening. And in the evening time, when we see the dust cloud raised by the hoofs of the cows and calves, we feel greatly delighted to get your darshan. As you return back, your curly locks of hair fall in front of your forehead, and when you look at everybody, your mother, father, and all the gopis and all the residents of Raja, with your loving glance and the smiling face and a charming look, at that time, unfortunately, our eyelids keep twinkling, because the foolish creator, Brahma, has created the eyelids due to which our eyes cannot constantly see you. Rather, it is interrupted by the movement of the eyelids. Nor are we such great devotees of you that we can take a scissor and clip off our eyelids. We can't do that. Since we can't do that, we consider ourselves fallen devotees. Like that they are praying. So like this, there are many prayers, very wonderful prayers the gopis sing in order to glorify Krishna and remember Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Everybody,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Kanat Dehina Papakarshanam Trinacharanugam Shriniketanam Fani Fanarpitam Tepadambujam Krinakusheshunah Krandihrachayam.
They are saying, Kanata Dehinam Papakarshanam. Anyone who takes shelter of Krishna's lotus feet, all their papa mountain is destroyed into powder. That is the power of, because your lotus feet has a thunderbolt symbol. The thunderbolt destroys the mountain into powder. So therefore, Aham Tvam Sarva Pape Bhyo Moksha Gishyami, as Krishna says. And then they are saying, Trinachara Anugam. Trina means grass. Chara means eating. Trinachara is the cows. Anuga means Krishna's lotus feet follows the cow's feet. That's the meaning. Cows walk ahead and Krishna walks behind. And then Fani Phanarpitam. You also put the lotus feet of yours on the head of Kaliya and danced beautifully. And by that dance, Kaliya became purified of all his poison. In this way, he became ultimately friendly to Krishna. Became freed from poison, he was no more a threat to the devotees and the others. Became friendly with Krishna and the devotees. So in this way, the power of Krishna's lotus feet they are discussing. There are many verses like this. Karasaroham kantakamadam. So in this way, by reading the prayer of prayers of the gopis, you understand the selfless and pure and devotional attitude of the gopis towards Krishna. This is Vrindavan. In Vrindavan, the covered boys are also completely dependent on Krishna. Whenever they saw any demon, covered boys wanted to be saved, not because they were afraid of their lives. In fact, even while entering the mouth of Aghasura, the covered boys had no fear at all. They were dancing while entering. They were clapping their hands. And when one covered boy asked, "What if this is a snake and we die?" Other covered boy said, "Why should we bother about it? Because this is Bakari is here with us. Who is Bakari? Bakari is Krishna. Bakari is a killer of Baka. He is with us. And then why should we fear? Bakavan Viranshasi," they said. Just as Bakasura was torn apart by Krishna, same way our Krishna will kill this Agasura also. One more asura for him. It's all a cakewalk for him. Like that, they said. They were very confident. On the other hand, demigods in the sky, even after drinking even after drinking amritam, still they were worried, still they were afraid. Maybe the Akasura will finish the Lord and his associates, and what will happen to us? So, covered boys are all totally dependent on Krishna. In Vrindavan, they are the thickest friends of Krishna. They play several types of sports with Krishna. They imitate the, frogs. And the frogs when they jump into Yamuna, they also jump into Yamuna. They catch the shadows of the birds. They also sit next to a duck. And when the swan is gracefully moving, they also try to move gracefully like a swan. And Krishna imitates a peacock dancing. They sometimes yell in the wells and they criticize the echoes and they sometimes gliding down in the trees in Vrindavan. Sometimes they make a jula under a tree and they play in the jula. Sometimes they play ice boy game. Krishna is supposed to close his eyes and later on search for the covered boys and find them out. In the afternoon time they sit together and eat lunch in the Vanabhoj, the bank of Yamuna. So the topmost spiritual bliss is available for the residents of Raja in Goloka Vrindavana. where there is no school to go, no exams to write, no company to go, no family to be maintained, nobody has to put the sweat and toil to work hard and have a bank balance. None of it. There is no old age, there is no disease, there is no death. So the Goloka Vrindavana is a place where it's a very homely atmosphere. Lord and his devotees, eternal associates, in the Sakya Rasa or Vatsala Rasa, Madhuri Rasa. So amongst all the different rasas, Madhuri Rasa is considered the topmost, about which we described. So, and in Vrindavan, this place is considered very special, which is the Govardhan. Why? Because the gopis themselves say, headed by Radharani, they glorify Govardhan as the best of the Haridasas. Actually, there are three Haridasas glorified in the scriptures. One is Yudhishthira Maharaj, another one is Uddhava, and third one is Govardhan. All are called as Haridas. They are all considered very, very special Haridasas. Amongst them, the gopis are the best devotees and they are certifying Govardhan as Haridasa Varya.
हंताय मद्रि अबलाम हरिदास वर्यो यत् राम कृष्ण चरण स्पर्श प्रमोद मानम तनोति सह गो गण यो नो यस पानीय सूय वस कंदर कंद मूल ही
इन दिस वर्स द गोपीज आर सेइंग हे गोवर्धन यू आर द बेस्ट ऑफ द डिवोटीज वाई हंतायम Adri Abalam Haridasa Varyo. Yet Rama Krishna Charana means Balarama and Krishna. They put their charana sparsha. They touch you with their lotus feet by climbing up your mountain along with the covered boys. There are plateaus there where they can play games. There are ponds there where they can play games. There are caves there. Then it is hot sun, they can go inside the cave. And they can eat with the covered boys and relax there. And there are waterfalls coming. They can bathe in the waterfalls. There are sliding portions of the Govardhan where they play games sliding from the Govardhan. And even at night, the Govardhan has the stones of Govardhan are translucent. They glow like radium. And also the Govardhan has fresh green grass, which is very much loved by the cows and calves of Krishna, who eat those grasses and they become very healthy and they get nourished by the grass. They give wonderful milk for Krishna. And also the Govardhan stones, they become like rubber when Krishna walks over them, so that they will give a very soft feeling. And adding to all these things, the Govardhan, although it doesn't speak loudly, silently the Govardhan renders all these varieties of services for Krishna. Most important service he did was when Krishna lifted the Govardhan hill like an umbrella, like you see in the picture, and gave shelter to all the Vajabhasis, to all the, during the time when Indra was sending thunderbolts and heavy rains and clouds and Samvartaka clouds. At that time, all Vajabhasis could take shelter of Govardhan, which was held by Krishna with his left hand lotus like palm and lotus like small tiny finger. So he invited everybody to take shelter of Govardhan. So to compare this Govardhan with Indra, Indra is also a devotee of the Lord. And Govardhan also a devotee of the Lord. But what is the difference? Indra has an egoistic propensity. So he is not doing service, he is only doing disservice to Lord and the devotees. And you can see how much hard work is he doing, throwing thunderbolt, yelling at the demigod, and calling some of the cloud to come and pour down. He is endeavoring very hard, putting sweat and toil to cause damage. Whereas Govardhan doesn't make any noise. Silently is rendering service. Abundant varieties of services. So we should learn from Govardhan how the Vajabhasi's heart is. They don't speak much, they enter services. They are very fond of serving the Lord. Therefore, they are the most dearest devotees. So, in this way, the Govardhan is considered very special in Vrindavan. And in Govardhan, Radhakund is the most special. Like that this verse says. Actually, if you go around Govardhan, there are many places to see. You know? There is a Kusum Sarovar. And then after Kusum Sarovar, if you go ahead, you will find the Govindakund will come. Where Indra surrendered to Krishna. In this way, then if you go to various places like that, you will find Punjari Kalota Baba will come. In the return journey, when you are coming, you will see Radhakund, Shyamakund in one place. So, this Radhakund is the highest, he says, even in Govardhan. See, it began with Vaikuntha. Better than Vaikuntha is Mathura, he said. Better than Mathura is Vrindavan. And better than Vrindavan in general is Govardhan Hill. And in Govardhan Hill, there are various spots. Most important spot, he says, is Radhakund, the topmost place to go. And the greatest of the purest of the Krishna devotees reside in Radhakund and constantly chant his holy names, constantly take shelter of his lotus feet. Like that it is said. So, why this Radhakund is so special? I had narrated this elaborately in Demons in Vrindavan Leela. There we had explained about Arishtasaruvada. There was a very dangerous bull, huge bull, who made loud noises. In Vrindavan, he is an asura who took the form of a bull. Rupa Goswami says that why the asuras would take the form of a bull, because they thought Krishna is very fond of cow and bull, he will not kill us. Therefore, they would take such a form. And he came, by his very loud noise, some women had miscarriages because of that. And with his horn, he would pound the ground and dig the ground. So, that Arishasura, when he created a great fear, in the hearts of everybody, Krishna came forward and said, "Hey, you rogue, why are you making noise and making everybody afraid here? If you really have the strength, face me." And he stood right in front of him. Yeah. And then the bull wanted to charge on Krishna's chest with his horns. Krishna very, very powerfully defeated him. And just like we wash dhoti in the bathroom, pat, we hit like that. He turned his horns. And then he hit him on the ground several times. And of course, Asura was killed. But then the gopis saw this whole sight. They came and told Krishna that, "Hey, since you have killed a male cow, so we will not be able to join your pastimes. We will not spend time with you henceforth because you have become a sinner now." So Krishna said, "You have any idea for me how I can get rid of sin?" So the gopis said, "You have to go to all the holy places and take a dip and come so that all your sins are eradicated." So Krishna said, "Oh, that will take a long time to go to different tirthas. Yeah, why to go to tirthas? I will just invite them all here." So he invited them and he just dug with his toe. And all the holy rivers came there. And gopis were amazed. So Krishna took a dip there and came out and said, "Gopis, do you agree now?" Now, all the holy rivers also showed themselves in their personified forms also. With folded palms. So gopis developed full trust. That actually all the rivers came. All the rivers thanked Lord Krishna for giving them opportunity to serve him. Now Krishna told the gopis, "Now my turn is over. Now your turn has come, gopis. You are also sinners," he said. And they asked, "Why? Why do you call us sinners? We actually defended a cow." He said, "Yes, in the name of defending a male cow, you defended an asura. So because you have patted, you have taken the side of asura, therefore, you have become sinful," he said. So then he asked, "What are we supposed to do?" Krishna said, "You also have to take a holy dip in all the rivers and come." Then Radharani told her friends that, "We will dig our pond here and we will bring all the holy rivers here." So Radharani dug and all the gopis also did that. And then Krishna requested Radharani that, "You know, because you all have dug the ground, but how will you get all the waters? You can take water from this kund." They said, no, "Your kund is impure. You already taken bath in that. To relieve your sin, we cannot take that," they were saying. Then all the holy rivers fell at the feet of Srimati Radharani and they begged, "Oh, divine universal mother, you know, you are Karunamayi. So we all have come here to serve the Lord, but we also wish to serve you. If you give us an opportunity, we will, flood your kund with our sacred waters." And Radharani smiled and said, okay, so be it, as per your desire. You all are desiring to serve, I will not say no. Shallot. Immediately the waters which were in the Shyamakund, they overflowed, and the Radhakund became flooded. On that day, Krishna declared many things. One of the first things he told Radharani, that Radharani, this kunda is made up of your liquid prema. It is because of, with great love, you and the gopis have participated in this pastime. So, as much as this kunda is dear to you, it is also dear to me. So, in fact, it is more dear to me than Shyamakunda also. Radhakunda is more dear to me. And anyone who takes a dip in this holy pond will become flooded with Krishna prema. He said, and you will become blessed by your mercy. So, there are many things Krishna said there. So, therefore, it is considered the most special place. When Srila Prabhupada brought the Western disciples to India, and he took them to Radhakunda, when they were all entering into the waters, they were splashing water and playing, and Prabhupada became very upset. He told everybody to come out. When they came out, Prabhupada said, what do you think about this? This is liquid prema. Actually, this is non-different from Srimati Radharani. He said, henceforth, nobody should enter the waters and play in the waters. With great reverence, take some few droplets of water, drink it, and put it on your head, and beg to Srimati Radharani to bless you with her mercy, as the Prabhupada said. So, this is considered the topmost dham in the entire creation. So, see, this flow chart gives you briefly how Vaikuntha means the spiritual world, the transcendental realm beyond this material existence. And it is three-fourths of the creation, Tripada Vibhuti, it is superior to material world. But better than Vaikuntha is Mathura, because Krishna appeared there. Although Mathura is located in material world, it is still superior to Vaikuntha, like the Prabhupada writes. But better than Mathura, I showed you Mathura has also a great reverence in everything. Vrindavana is very special because there is Dwadashavan. 12 forests are there. And also, it is very famous. Vrindavana is famous for Krishna's pastimes with gopis, gopars, Nanda Baba, Yashoda, all of them. It's a very, very special place. Better than Vrindavan is Govardhan Hill, because Krishna lifted the Govardhan Hill and Krishna tends cows and calves in the Govardhan Hill also. He performs pastimes with Radharani and gopis there in the Radhakund. And therefore, in Govardhan Hill, the best place is Radhakund. Because it is at the foot of Govardhan Hill. And also, love for Krishna overflows. I told you the pastime now, isn't it? And it is a site for many, many loving pastimes. And great souls like Raghunath Das Goswami lived there. Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself, when he went to Vrindavan, the first thing he was searching is, where is Radhakund? He searched and searched. At one spot in the game, he understood, this is the Radhakund. Because Lord Chaitanya is non-different from Krishna, with the bhava of, mahabhava of Radharani. So he could immediately detect the place. And there was some water there. But then he eventually arranged for his devotees to dig and make the place a proper pond to excavate the holy waters. Again, Radhakund and Shyamakund. So, it was rediscovered by Lord Chaitanya and excavated by Raghunath Das Goswami and others. And it is most dear place for Gaudiya Vaishnavas. Other Sampradaya people may not know the glory of Radhakunda. But Gaudiya Vaishnavas know it. Our acharyas have handed it over in the line. Those who are not engaged in devotion service, they should not be told the glory of all this. But those who are very fortunate to come in Brahma Madhava Gaudiya Sampradaya, they will get to know this fact. So, whenever you go for Vrindavan Yatra, we should go to this spot. Radhakund, bow down our head. It's a very good place to pray for Radharani's mercy, to purify our heart and advance in spiritual life. So, here I have shown you both Govardhan, lifting of Krishna, the picture you see. And also, below I have shown Krishna and the gopis dancing in the moonlit night. It's a beautiful picture. In this way, Radhakund is a place where Krishna performs amazing pastimes. Ashtakaliya Leela, in different times of the day, different pastimes happen there. So, now you read it. The same is elaborated here. Yeah.
The spiritual world is 3/4 of the total creation of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, and it is the most exalted region. The spiritual world is naturally superior to the material world. However, Mathura and the adjoining areas, although appearing in the material world, are considered superior to the Vaikuntha because the Supreme Personality of Godhead Himself appeared at Mathura.
Yeah. So, there is one verse which appears in the first canto. Anyonyamasit sanjalpa uttamashloka chetasam kauravendra purastrinam sarvashruti manoharaha. When Lord Krishna was in Hastinapuram, the Kauravendra Purastrinam, they all climbed up the top of the roof, and from there they showered flowers upon Krishna, and they were watching Krishna walking in the street, and they were all doing some talk, and that talk is recorded in the Srimad Bhagavatam, and that is glorified like anything by Sukadeva Goswami. Now, if women talking, what will they talk about? They'll talk about, what did you cook today? Your dress is like this, my dress is like this. They'll talk about that marriage of their daughters or the job of their sons. Or they'll talk about the golden bangles or golden necklaces, you know. Or they'll talk about, you know, what their husbands gifted them. So, women generally, ordinary women, those who are not yet devotees, non-devotee women, are considered to be materialistic, generally speaking. They are concerned about material welfare only. Whereas, these women who are standing at the top, they were all pure devotees of Krishna. So, although they were talking amongst themselves, that is recorded in Bhagavatam, because you know what they were talking? They were talking that Lord Krishna, residing in Dwaraka, is very opulent, and he marries all the 16,108 queens, and he lives with each of them in one palace, and gives them nice costly saris and ornaments, and he also gives his own personal company, stays with them. Although these queens are undoubtedly very fortunate, but they are not the ultimately fortunate, because more fortunate than them are the devotees in Mathura, those are living in Mathura, because Mathura is the birthplace of Krishna. Those residing in Mathura, like Devaki, Vasudeva, and other residents of Mathura, they are very fortunate. And then they are saying, better than Mathura also is Vrindavana. Because in Vrindavana, the Lord, this Lord who is walking in the road now, simply by the mere glance of His, He is creating the millions of universes, Sa Aishyata, Sa Srijata, He is doing all that. But now, when He has come in Vrindavana as a small boy, who is a covered boy, playing with covered other boys and dancing with the gopis and becoming a darling of Yashoda. So, therefore, if one wants to see the Lord's real, eternal, sweet form, one should go to Vrindavan. They are the most fortunate, like that they are saying. So, therefore, it is said, Anyonyamasit Sanjalpa, Uttama Shloka Chetasam. They were all completely Krishna conscious. And then it said, Kauravendra Purastrinam Sarva Shruti Manoharaha. Even the Shrutis want to hear what they were speaking. It is said, Manoharaha. It was charming to the minds of anybody who would hear that talk, because it was all glorification of Krishna. Therefore, such a glorification of the Lord Krishna is more sweeter than the glorification of Lord of Vaikuntha, as shown here. So, we have shown Vaikuntha below and Mathura above. Then,
the interior forests of Vrindavan are considered superior to Mathura because of the presence of the 12 forests, Dwadashavana, such as Talavan, Madhuvan and Bahulavan, which are famous for the various pastimes of the Lord. Thus, the interior Vrindavan forest is considered superior to Mathura, but superior to these forests is the divine Govardhan hill, because Krishna lifted Govardhan hill like an umbrella, raising it with His lotus-like beautiful hand to protect His associates, the denizens of Vraja, from the torrential rains sent by the angry Indra, king of the demigods. It is also at Govardhan hill that Krishna tends the cows with His cowherd friends, and there also He had His rendezvous with His most beloved Sri Radha and engaged in loving pastimes with her. Yeah. Radha Kund at the foot of Govardhan is superior to all, because it is there that love of Krishna overflows. Advanced devotees prefer to reside at Radha Kund because this place is the site of many memories of eternal loving affairs between Krishna and Radharani, Rati Vilasa.
So, this is the picture of Radhakund we have put here. We put Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, who visited Vrindavan. So, in Vrindavan also, Lord Chaitanya, there's a beautiful song.
Dule dule gaura chan, hari guna gaye.
Like that's a song. So, that song shows about how even the parrots are discussing about Radha and Krishna. Even the Vrindavaner Tarur Lata, Prema Koye Hari Kata. Even the creepers of Vrindavan are speaking the glories of Krishna. The trees there in Vrindavan are all Kalpavruksha trees. The cows there in Vrindavan are all Surabhi cows, which give unlimited supply of milk any time of the day, all day. And all the every sand particle, dust particle, golden powder like sand at the bank of Yamuna is all Chintamani gems. And the Vajavasis' hearts are all completely pure, purest of the pure, because they have no Aishwarya Bhava. They simply love in Madhurya Bhava. So, even that type of wonderful Vrindavan place, the Govardhan, and then in Govardhan Radhakund, in this way our Rupa Goswami Pada has very crystal, in a crystal clear manner specified what is more and more holier. Radhakund is the holiest place. So, in this way, we started with Vachavegam, Manasavegam in this book, and we have come to the ninth verse, where the topmost holiest of the places is being revealed, and Raganuga Bhakti is being explained. So, we can make ourselves aware of these things, but we cannot imitate the great souls. So, there are some people foolishly leaving everything and going to Radhakund, and then they fell prey to illicit connections, and they could not perfect their spiritual life. So, we should be guided by the spiritual master and senior Vaishnavas and chant the holy names and follow the four related principles and lead a pure life following in footsteps of our Guru and Vaishnavas as Prabhupada has taught us in this parampara. And at the right time, one will get residence of Radhakund. In fact, one should make one's home itself Vrindavan, or one should go to the nearest ISKCON temple and enter Seva in this ISKCON temple, and then one will attain the perfections that are available for all devotees mentioned in these verses. So, now we have a couple of more verses, 10 and 11, which we will do. 10 is a long verse, we will take one more class, and then we'll conclude later on with one more class with 11 we will do. So, we will take a couple of more classes to complete the next rough instruction book. Thank you. Shri Prabhupada ki, Gaur Bhakta Vrinda ki,
Jai.